Hey, I'm Warren Spector. I'm the creative director at Junction Point Studios, part of Disney Interactive, and we're here at Disneyland talking about Disney Epic Mickey 2, The Power of Two.
And Warren, what are your thoughts on the Nintendo Wii U?
I'm a Nintendo geek, so I'm a pretty big Nintendo fan. The Wii U is pretty cool, and the thing that I'm most intrigued about it is it's the first gaming platform that actually is exploiting the second screen. I think you're going to see a lot more of that in the future. And the Wii U, in fairly typical Nintendo fashion, is there first.
And how are you utilizing the gamepad for Epic Mickey 2?
When you're dealing with a new platform, the real trick is just getting the game running. And we wanted to bring the HD experience to Nintendo fans. So that's the main thrust. The second screen we're using for a dynamically updating map. One of the things we heard about the first game was it was sometimes hard to know where you were and where you were supposed to go. So having a dynamically updated real-time map on that second screen is really powerful. We're also using it for sketches, using the anvil and the watch and the new fairy sketch and some of the other stuff. But it's mostly the HD experience on a Nintendo platform. That's the big thing for the Wii U.
And what's it like seeing, speaking of HD, what's it like seeing your creations in HD for the first time?
It's awesome. You know, it's funny because on the first game, no one has to agree with me, by the way, but I actually thought that the first game was the prettiest Wii game ever. I loved the way it looked, and I just didn't think the team could do any better. But the Wii version of Disney Epic Mickey 2 is even better than the first game. And when you see it in HD, I mean, it's amazing. I mean, the concept art and the game look identical now. It's pretty amazing.
And what do you see the Wii U opening up creatively to game developers moving forward?
Well, you know, I think a dynamically updating map screen is barely scratching the surface. I think having a second screen opens up all sorts of possibilities for entirely new kinds of games and new ways of approaching traditional kinds of games. I mean, the opportunity to do things for one player, to hide things from another player, that's huge. I mean, that's a part of so many card games and board games. I think we're clearly going to be taking advantage of things like that. I can't even imagine. I mean, honestly, I've been telling my boss, Bill Roper, over at Disney, just give me 6 months, give me a year just to play. Don't make me tell you what game I'm making. Just let me play with the Wii U, we'll come up with some cool stuff. I don't even know what I do yet. Sure, I've been dying for months to talk about all the new stuff. It's funny because despite having talked about, you know, the full voice, the co-op, the new lands you get to explore, I mean, all that stuff that we've talked about, I knew there were like half a dozen new game systems that were really going to radically change the experience of play, and I couldn't talk about any of them. So now we've got costumes that you'll have to find the individual parts of the costumes or buy them if you want. That actually change Mickey and Oswald's abilities. So you can change the way you can interact with the world based on what costume you're wearing. We have these ink wells throughout the world that you can change the state of them. So if you're playing in a particular way, you can turn them into indelible ink wells. Jump into them and you'll come out invulnerable for a while. Or if you're playing the game a different way, those ink wells will become invisible ink wells. And you'll be able to come out and as invisible and sneak around. We've got all sorts of pins and a photo mode and all sorts of stuff that just really allows you to customize the experience and make it what you want it to be to tell your story, which is what the Disney Epic Mickey games are all about.
And what's it like for you to visit Disneyland?
Dude, I turn into a six-year-old when I come to Disneyland. It's amazing. My eyes glass over, my blood pressure goes down. I'm just like everybody else. I turn into a big kid when I come here. It's the happiest place on earth, right?
And what do you think of the new Cars Land?
You know, I just got there for the first time last night, actually. And so I haven't been able to stand online long enough to go on any of the rides yet, but I assume the rides are great. And there's something pretty amazing about just standing in the middle of a CGI movie. I mean, you really feel like you're in Radiator Springs. I mean, there you are. So kind of makes me wonder what a wasteland would look like. Maybe someday we'll see a game inspire a land at Disneyland too.
That's what I was going to ask is, do you think movies like Cars Land and other Pixar movies will play a role in future Epic Mickey games?
I don't know. We'll see. I've sort of counseled the team and sort of think myself that we want to steer clear of Pixar there. Wasteland is the world of the forgotten and the rejected, and so it's partly that, clearly, I mean, Pixar's track record of success doesn't have a lot of rejected stuff in it, right? Yeah, boy, we should all be so lucky. But it's also, you know, you'll notice there isn't a lot of more recent Disney animation or Disney feature film stuff in Wasteland either. And it's because, you know, we actually get to interact with the people who made those movies. And I don't want to be the guy who says, wow, that work you did last year, that was really no good, man. It's in Wasteland now. I mean, I'm not going to be that guy.